Today we're going to talk about cooling fans using the stepper extender. So I need to review a couple things here. I've already set up the steppers on the power output ports. So we have extruder number 2 and extruder number 1. And we also set up the thermistors for them. Now what we need to talk about is where we're going to mount the stepper extender. So we have a set of pins here for our servo ports. We have 4 across here and then it goes 3 down. And this is our ground set of pins. This is our 5 volt set of pins. And this is our digital pins. So the digital pins are digital pin 4, digital pin 5, digital pin 6, and digital pin 11. The only two that we're actually concerned with are digital pin 6 and 11. And underneath here, we have our connections for it. So we're going to place it over those pins, apply a little bit of thumb pressure to push it down. And then in order to connect it, we have to connect our 12 volt connection because you can't use 24 with this. So on the outside is 12 volts. And then the inside pin, which is black, is ground. Now that's going to be the same over here. If I get it backwards, you can always flip this cable when the power's off. Next thing you want to do is connect your fans. So we're going to connect one 12 volt fan. And then the other. Okay, next thing we want to do is connect the USB power cable and programming cable. So we're going to connect the big side to the USB port and the small side to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. Now keep in mind, after it is energized or connected, there's voltage running through here, so you don't want to touch the board. And in a moment, I'll show you in Marlin how to set up the firmware. Okay, we're going to open up the Marlin bug fix 119 bug fix. We're going to go into the Marlin subfolder. We're then going to press B for the board and open up boards. And what we need to do is search on MKS. And what we have here is the board underscore MKS underscore Gen underscore L. We're going to copy that. Then we're going to close out of this. And we're going to press M on the keyboard and open up the Marlin solution file or marlin.ino. Okay, now that we're in the Marlin ino file, we're going to go to the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a search on motherboard. And then what we're going to do is we're going to replace board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB with what we copied from the boards file. So we're going to paste it here. So now we have board underscore MKS underscore Gen underscore L. So now we're going to go over to the Configuration Advanced tab, and we're going to do a search on fans. And what we're looking for here is extruder cooling fan. And what we want to do is we want to scroll down and see if we can find the section for the pins for extruder 0 and extruder 1, which is 1 and 2. It's just the way they write it for the computer. So the pins that we want to set are 6 for the digital pin, and the other one being 11. And this will be for our first and second extruder being the 11 one. So now we want to scroll down and see what we have for our auto temp. This is the temperature in which it goes on, and it's set right now to 50 degrees Celsius. So I'm going to back this down to about 30 degrees Celsius just to make it safe for the example. And I'm going to leave alone the fan speed so that you can play with that on your own. But right now it's set to max of 255. You can always set it lower if you so choose. But for now, what we're going to do is load the firmware. So we're going to select our COM port. And then we're going to check to make sure that we have the right board selected. In this case, it uses the Mega 2560 chipset. So we're good there. So the next thing we're going to do is compile and upload. And in a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface how to test it. Okay, before we can actually test it, we have to energize it with 12 volts. So I'm going to plug this in. Now keep in mind that you don't want to touch the board once it's energized. Now that it's energized, it's unsafe to be around. So now I'm going to open up Pronterface. And I'm going to connect to the device. Now for those that don't know, I've set in previous tutorials, being the dual extruder tutorials, the tool set so that we can change between one and two extruders right here. So the next thing that we want to do is we want to change our temperature here so that it's a little bit lower. So we're going to say that it's 35 degrees Celsius. And right now we're on the first extruder. So I'm going to press set, and I'll let you watch as the fan actually turns on. So here we go. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.